In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Hebrews says that the Word of God is sharp and powerful. It speaks to our innermost being. I want to speak to you tonight, as you rest, that you're important and special, that God's hand is on your life. The psalmist David said, "You made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit them together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderful." It's amazing to think about. "Your workmanship is marvelous, and how well I know it." It even says that, "God, you were there while I was being formed in a hidden place. You saw me even before I was born, and you scheduled each day of my life before I began to breathe. Every day of my life has been recorded in your book." How precious it is, O Lord, to realize that you're thinking about me constantly. I can't even count how many times a day your thoughts are turned towards me. And when I awake in the morning, you will still be thinking of me. See, you are a gift from God. Psalms 127 says, "The children are God's best gift. The fruit of the womb is his generous legacy." How blessed are your parents because their quiver has been filled with children. Your enemies don't stand a chance against you. You'll sweep them right off their feet. I want to declare to you today, you're a gift from God. You were made by God. You're a gift to your parents. Because you're in this family, we have a great future. We know that our enemies will never be able to defeat us because God's grace is on your life. I want to speak over you now that you were fearfully and wonderfully made. There's something about the design of your life that's very unique. Nobody's like you. When God made you, he said it's marvelous. And he wants you to know that what he did in you is like nothing else he did in anybody else. Even while you were in your mother's stomach, he was in relationship with you, forming you and making you. And every day of your life has been recorded in his book. And when you wake up tomorrow, he's going to still be thinking about you. As you get ready to rest, Psalms 4, verse number 8 says, "I will lie down in peace and sleep, for you alone, O Lord, will keep me safe." Psalms 34:7 says, "God's angels have set up a circle of protection around us while we rest." Psalms 91, verse 11 and 12 says, "He ordered his angels to guard you wherever you go. And if you stumble, they'll catch you. Their job is to keep you from falling." 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse number 7 says, "You don't need to be afraid, for God's given you power and love and a sound mind." Tonight, you will rest well. You will not be afraid. God's special angels are protecting you while you rest. They watch over you all day long and even while you sleep. Their job is to help you. I proclaim over your life that you will be free from fear. You will not have bad dreams. You will not be awakened in torment, but you will rest well and your sleep will be blessed. In Jesus' name.